Apart from the reuse, we have a Kosovo project called Blocker. We use this to collect all the research that we have done from the beginning to the end of the project. I was able to access the Blogger app onto my phone and record and track my progress. This allowed me to use the app whenever there was internet access, and therefore it enabled me to keep up to date with all the projects and all the work that I needed to do. Before choosing the song, artist or genre of the music video we wanted to do, we used the media platform YouTube to research into the indie pop / indie rock genre. We were able to use Spotify to research into the songs, and we were able to use YouTube to research into the music videos. I used SlideShare to research into the conventions of indie pop and other genres. This allowed me to see what was needed for the indie pop genre in comparison to other genres. We researched into Sabrina Claudio's Confidently Lost. This inspired us by the strange shot types and inspired us to play with the camera movement in our music video. YouTube is easily usable and free, which has made it easier for us to view the video over and over again. Furthermore, we can embed YouTube videos into our Blogger account so we can explore the video in greater detail. Using YouTube, I was able to research into music videos of the genre and gave us inspiration into what kind of music video we wanted to make ourselves. To get feedback from my target audience, I asked several of my target audience questions in relation to the genre of indie pop. I use messaging apps, WhatsApp, Instagram and Facebook to gain information from my target audience. I use these apps because they're instant and it allows me to gain an immediate response. Throughout the course of filming our music video, we use the software of Spotify and the hardware of our phones to play the music out loud and repeatedly. This allowed us to gain accurate lip sync. Also, I used our phones to take location pictures and vlogs that we put up on our blog. We use WhatsApp to communicate with each other about when and where our location and our filmings are going to take place. To film, we use a Nikon D3000 camera. This is an easy camera to use and produces high quality videos. It allows instant playback, which can help us determine whether the video that we captured was good enough to be used in our music video. Throughout the course, we used the editing software iMovie to put different effects onto our video, which gave our video a unique feel. We were able to import our clips easily onto iMovie, therefore making it easy for us to access all the clips that we needed to edit. iMovie allowed us to put filters onto our narrative parts of our video, making it darker. We also used the slow motion tool to make the clips slower, to make them synchronous to our song. We also overlapped videos on top of one another, adding the opacity and the fade tool to give the video a disorientated feel. We also used Adobe's Premiere Pro to edit very, very quick shots that we wouldn't have been able to do on iMovie. I use Prezi because it's an easy software to use. I'm able to navigate the format that they give me easily, and I'm able to present my response and the evaluation clearly with good description on Prezi.